Hello everyone, how are you? Feeling good? Okay. Today we will continue chapter number 6 from history, that is towns, traders and craft persons, part 2. So before moving to part 2, let us have a small recap of what we have studied in our previous classes. We studied about the different types of towns. It may be the temple towns, it may be the administrative towns, or it may be any other town. So that town gains importance because of the it may be because of the temple or because of the administrative work or the cultural activities. We studied about the temple towns like Tirumalai, that is in southern part of India, and Mathura Vrindavan, that is in the northern part of India. And we also studied about the administrative towns. Some of the towns, they become proper because of the administration, the Chola kingdom. They had their capital city, Madurai. So it all become important because of the capital or because of the administration of that particular kingdom. So then we studied about the traders, we studied about the craft persons, we have seen the splendid architectural beauty of Hampi, the Vijayanagara kingdom, so Manigramam, Mandapika, that is Mandi, that is also called as Hatta. So all these things we have studied in our previous class, and on Monday, that is today, we are going to see the same in the module as well. So you have to go through the videos as well. So okay, then only you will be able to understand the entire concept. Okay, without wasting our time, let us move on to today's concept. Let us see what it is. We have studied about the architectural beauty of Hampi. That is one of the important towns flourished in the medieval period. And today we are going to study one more city, that is Surat, a gateway to the west. Now, a gateway to the west means what? A gateway, gateway to the west, that is to the western part of the country or the western world. It may be for Europe, it may be for America, or it may be for Africa. So as India is towards the eastern part of the world, so whatever is there, then all the countries or the continents are to the west of India. So it is a gate to the west because Surat is situated on the coastal area of, or on the coast of Arabian Sea. So that is why it is a port city. It was a very important port city during the medieval period. So it is a gateway to the west. Means वहाँ से पूरा यूरोप से वो पूरा क्रॉस करके सूरत में आते थे, और सूरत से वो इंडिया के डिफरेंट पार्ट को, और अंदर से आइदर बाय कारवांस और आइदर बाय एनी अदर मोड ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन दे यूज टू रीच टू देयर डेस्टिनेशन. सो लेट अस नाउ स्टडी इन डिटेल अ गेटवे टू द वेस्ट, दैट इज सूरत. सूरत फेम्ड फॉर, ओके लेट मी लिटिल बिट ज़ूम फॉर यू. सूरत famed matlab it become famous. Surat famed for being the emporium of western trade during the Mughal period and gateway for trade with the West Asia. So it is become a, I can say, important trade center at the time of the Mughals only, and the same continued even the time of the British. It was also called the gate to Mecca is situated, that is a holy place of the Muslims, and it is situated towards the western part of India. The cosmopolitan city, cosmopolitan means the city in which different varieties of people are found, speaking different languages, following different culture, that is called cosmopolitan city. Even you can say that Ahmedabad, Gujarat, this whole Gujarat is a cosmopolitan city only, except the typical areas where the trades or where the industries are not flourished. You can say even Ankleshwar is also a cosmopolitan city. People following different religion, from different regions, speaking different languages, they are all settled here, and that is why it is a cosmopolitan city. So the cosmopolitan city had people from all caste and creed, that is Surat. Even today we can witness the same. and the Portuguese, the Dutch and the English had their factories and warehouses at Surat. So warehouses, you can say that you just like what in simple word we can say that go down type, they had their warehouses, because from the ships or from the big ships or other transportation, sea transportation, all the materials they used to reach to Surat. And from Surat से उसको unloading करना है ना, unloading करके तो कहीं तो एक जगह पर रखना है, उसके लिए क्या चाहिए, एक तो गोडाउन चाहिए और वहाँ से जहाँ destination है वहाँ तक वो पहुँचता था. So they had their factories as well as their warehouses. Surat textile was world famous for the gold lace borders. So gold lace border, you will be able to see clearly this in the module. Okay, Surat textile was world famous for its gold borders, gold lace border. Let's move. Did I miss anything? No. Okay. Let me zoom. The Kathiawad Seth or the Mahajans had huge banking houses. So Seth, Kathiawadi Seth. Seth itself is a banker. So the Kathiawadi Seth or the Mahajans had huge banking houses. Surat hundis were honored in the far off market. So that is, you will be able to find that Surat hundi karke, wo image mein aapko dikhaya jayega in the, I will explain, try to explain that in the module whenever I'm sharing, that with the image it is shown that ek envelope jaisa hai, usme seal le kiya hua rehta hai, and that is a hundi called. Surat hundis were honored in far off market, matlab bahut dur dur ka market mein bhi usko they used to honor. Surat began to decline towards the end of 17th century because of the loss of markets, decrease in productivity, control of sea route by the Portuguese and the British. Due to all these things, the importance of Surat as a you can say market, it started diminishing or declining या deteriorating और उसका famous कम होते गया. What is the reason? Maybe the loss of market, market नहीं रहा या market, अभी जैसे कि corona situation है तो कितना market, market कितना down है. You might have heard people saying the market has gone down, and the same thing is there happened during the 17th century for Surat. Decrease in productivity, productivity जो भी production है सब हो गया था, all of a sudden it saw a fall. Then control of sea route by the Portuguese and the British, and earlier it may be the Dutch as well as the French, they had their factories at Surat. So now the British as well as the Portuguese, they occupied. Surat is even today a bustling commercial center, very busy, isn't it? People from all parts of India, they come, they settle over here, they seek business here, and they flourish their activities, trades and everything here. So even today it is one of the busy commercial center. Commercial is earning money, or you can say that business bahut acha hota hai Surat mein. Now another place, now Surat is over, now another one important center, or you can say town, that we are going to see today is Musalipattanam, or it is also called as Machalipattanam. Machli, you know, Machli, Machli jal ki rani hai, oh wahi Machli. So Musalipattanam or Machalipattanam. So Musalipattanam lay on the delta of Krishna river and was a center of intense activity in the 17th century. So this is on the eastern part of India, so Andhra Pradesh. So it is Musalipattanam or Musalipattanam is in Andhra Pradesh. Let us see whether it is in Andhra Pradesh or Telangana after the partition. I don't remember exactly, we will let you know. So it is in Andhra Pradesh, or it was there in Andhra Pradesh before the partition. So in the 17th century it was one of the most you can say active town. The Dutch and the English attempted to control Musalipattanam. So why they are now occupying, you have to see that all these, they didn't come to the inner part, they didn't come to Baroda, they didn't come to Madhya Pradesh, or they didn't come to any other part. Why? They wanted to have their control on the cities, they had their port, पोर्ट जो है, क्योंकि उनका जो भी है वेस्टर्न कंट्री का कनेक्शन उनको शिप के थ्रू आना था, और उनको जो पोर्ट जो है, जो जहाँ जहाज को उनको अच्छे से वो पार करके कर सकते हैं अपलोड सॉरी अनलोड लोड कर सकते, ऐसा उनको प्लेस चाहिए था। इसीलिए उनको जहाँ बिल्कुल समुंदर से अंदर वाला प्लेस उनको नहीं चाहिए, दे ऑल वांट टू कंट्रोल द पोर्ट सिटी ओनली। सो मसलीपट्टनम इज आल्सो वन ऑफ द पोर्ट सिटी, एंड द डच एंड द इंग्लिश दे ट्राई टू कंट्रोल। द कुतुब शाही रूलर्स ऑफ गोलकोंडा इम्पोज्ड रॉयल मोनोपोली ऑन द सेल ऑफ टेक्सटाइल्स स्पाइसिस एट्सेट्रा टू प्रिवेंट द ट्रेड पासिंग टू various foreign trading company. So at that time the Qutub Shahi rulers, they were ruling Golconda, okay, Golconda, Hyderabad, Golconda rulers, and they imposed a monopoly on sale of textiles. Monopoly means there is no competition. If you are selling the thing, so if there is no competition, that is called as monopoly. अगर आप मार्केट में जाते हो तो आपको दूध लेना है, तो दूध लेना अगर एक ही जगह पे मिलता है, दैट इज़ कॉल्ड दैट ही इज सेलिंग, ओनली वन पर्सन इज सेलिंग, ओके, फ्रॉम द शॉप इफ यू वांटेड टू, देन दैट इज़ कॉल्ड मोनोपोली। ही मे चार्ज ही मे वॉट एवर द प्राइस ही वांट, बट इफ देर आर सो मेनी और आई कैन से शॉप्स सेलिंग द मिल्क और द इक्वल प्रोडक्ट, देन देर वोंट बी मोनोपोली। सो इफ ही इज चार्जिंग हाई, पीपल विल गो टू द नेक्स्ट दुकान में जाते हैं, दे विल गो टू द नेक्स्ट शॉप एंड बाई द प्रोडक्ट। सो जब मोनोपोली दे पुट मोनोपोली, दे सेड दैट कि वी आर ओनली सेलिंग द टेक्सटाइल्स, नो वन एल्स, एज वेल एज स्पाइसिस, टू प्रिवेंट द ट्रेड पासिंग टू डिफरेंट trading, foreign trading companies. Otherwise, if there is no monopoly, if there is any, there was no competition, the Dutch, the French, the British, all will come to control or to have their trade. Now, competition among various trading companies made the city populous and prosperous. Because of the competition of various trading companies, they tried to compete each other, and it made the city most populous as well as prosperous. Prosperous, rich. Now Aurangzeb annexed Golconda, annexed matlab captured Golconda in 1686 and 1687, leading European companies took alternatives. Alternatives ko abhi wo unhone kabza kar liya, now we have to find some alternative method. Musulipatnam declined as company traders moved to Bombay, Kolkata and Madras. They moved afterwards. Now, new towns and traders. Next concept. The English, the Dutch and the French formed East India Company. Yes, we studied English East India Company, French East India Company, Dutch East India Company, Portuguese East India Company, separate East India Companies, to expand their commercial interest. That is, means to expand their trade. They used their naval power, that is the navy power, to control gain over sea trade and forced Indians to work as agent. They forced the Indians to work as agent for them. The English finally emerged as successful commercial and political power in India. Yes, we know that afterwards, first of all, the British, they had so many competition from the Portuguese, the Dutch, the French. Now, finally, the British, they able to defeat everyone, and ultimately, they established their control, later on political control. They ruled us for so many years. And Indian textiles gained more fame. Fame means famous, but the number of craft persons declined after losing their independence. So they craft persons, earlier there was demand, so they used to produce more and more good quality of work. Now the demand is not there, so ultimately the craft persons, they now shifted to some other work. Bombay, Madras, Calcutta rose in 18th century, and the crafts and the commerce underwent major changes. Black towns and white townships developed in these cities. Black towns for the Indians, white town for the British or for the foreigners. It may be the Portuguese, it may be the Dutch, but actually we are talking about the British, the white township. Separate township, separate vyavastha unke liye rehne ke liye. ओके, ब्लैक्स एक जगह पे रहेंगे तो वाइट्स अलग कॉलोनी में रहेंगे, क्योंकि वो टच नहीं करेंगे. सो दैट दे फॉलोड द फॉल दिस पॉलिसी ऑफ डिवाइड एंड रूल. ओके, सो दैट्स ऑल अबाउट टूडेज लेसन और अबाउट दिस लेसन. सो यू हैव टू गो थ्रू द टेक्स्ट बुक. इट इज योर ड्यूटी टू रीड द टेक्स्ट बुक बिकॉज आई हैव मेंशनड और आई हैव ट्राइड टू कवर द मेन पॉइंट्स थ्रू पीपीटी, बट इट इज योर ड्यूटी टू गो थ्रू ईच एंड एवरी पॉइंट एक्सप्लेन्ड इन द चैप्टर. ओके, एंड ट्राई टू बी मोर प्रेजेंट ऑन जूम क्लासेस टू. इन द मीन टाइम कीप वॉचिंग, कीप स्टडिंग एंड कीप लर्निंग. थैंक यू, बाय बाय एंड हैव ए नाइस टाइम. हैप्पी नवरात्रि.